Now, this is Addison's disease. We just talked about Cushing's disease and syndrome. That was excess of the steroids. Addison's disease is an insufficiency, not enough. We've got a picture of President Kennedy there because he's a very famous person who also happened to have Addison's disease. So sometimes people remember this by Addison's disease means we need to add steroids because that's how we treat this disease. You have to replace all those steroids, those hormones that the adrenal gland would normally produce if it was functioning. So if I have Addison's disease, I don't have enough cortisol, aldosterone, or adrenaline. So look at all the processes that will affect. Yeah, a lot of them. But see, that's the cool part about the endocrine system. If Cushing's has these symptoms, then Addison's is going to be the exact opposite. So see, it's really straightforward. People oftentimes complain about the endocrine system, but I think it's one of the simplest yet complex things that you'll learn in nursing school. Now, how does someone end up with Addison's disease? Usually it's autoimmune. The sad part is we don't pick up the clinical symptoms until the patient's autoimmune system has really knocked out almost all of the gland, like up to 90% of it. But that's normally the cause of Addison's disease. Now, there's a secondary cause. If the anterior pituitary doesn't put out enough ACTH, this can also be a cause of Addison's disease. You'll likely see, if you see Addison's disease, you'll see number one most often. Now, the reason we're talking about this is not because we have all the time in the world. It's because this is what happens. An Addisonian crisis is what happens when someone with Addison's disease doesn't have enough hormones to respond to stress. It also happens when someone who's had Cushing's syndrome, they've received lots of corticosteroids, their adrenal gland has become suppressed, and now it can't respond because that patient stopped taking the medications. So that's why we're looking at Addison's disease and Cushing's. So the systemic effects of adrenal insufficiency or Addison's disease are the exact opposite of Cushing's. Remember in Cushing's, mood swings, all that stuff? No. These people are so tired, they don't have the energy to have mood swings. They have chronic fatigue all the time if they're not receiving enough replacement hormone. So now let's think about, well, we know what happened in Cushing's cardiovascularly. Oh, because of the aldosterone, you might have extra volume on board. Extra volume meant hypertension. So what would we see in Addison's? If it's the opposite, you would see low blood pressure, right? So you know that we'd have low blood pressure. What do you think the impact would be on the heart rate? Well, anytime I have low blood pressure, how does my body respond in heart rate? Oh yeah, it goes faster. So you'll have tachycardia. So you've got low blood pressure and tachycardia because of low volume. You have low volume because we don't have appropriate amounts of aldosterone. Whether I'm in Addison's disease or an Addisonian-like crisis because my adrenal gland has been suppressed by corticosteroids over a long period of time and it can't respond. So when a patient with Addison's disease or a suppressed adrenal gland undergoes stress, they need extra hormone replacement. Now fluid volume, we already talked about it, so you know that they're going to be dehydrated. How their electrolytes are going to be is the opposite of Cushing's. Cushing's was increased sodium because aldosterone tells you to hang on to sodium. So in Addison's, it's got to definitely be decreased sodium and therefore increased potassium. So see, now you could look at electrolyte lab values and know which one was likely Cushing's and which one was likely Addison's. Good work. Now, they crave salty foods. That seems kind of obvious, right? Because they don't have the aldosterone. They're not hanging on to sodium. They have lower sodium. And that's one of the ways my body will protect itself. When I have hyponatremia, it's going to tell me to eat or ingest more salt. Now, I also have some GI weird ones that are not very fun. They have nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea, which could be very problematic if you start thinking about fluid and electrolyte balance, because you're going to end up throwing that off if you have pretty extreme nausea and vomiting and diarrhea. Blood sugar in Cushing's was high. So what do you think it would be in Addison's? It's got to be the opposite, right? So it's low. Hypoglycemia. So we've talked about comparing these system by system. Cushing, mood swings, Addison's, too tired for that, right? Volume in Cushing's, up. Hypertension. In Addison's, it's the opposite. Volume down, hypotension, fast heart rate. Blood sugar up in Cushing's, blood sugar low in Addison's. You also have a muscle weakness, and think about that with the electrolyte imbalance. That's part of the problem. So head to toe, we've looked at adrenal insufficiency or Addison's. We looked at this because it's the mirror image of Cushing's. Good. And that also means it applies to patients that have Cushing's syndrome because they've been on long-term higher-dose corticosteroid therapy and their adrenal gland has been suppressed. And an Addisonian-like crisis is similar to when someone who has an adrenal gland that's been suppressed and they stop taking their medication too quickly.